YouTube, Dorsey May Gaming here, y'all. And this video is not going to be long. We're going to get straight to the point. In our fourth episode of the Immersive Innovative Series for Madden NFL 19, I would like to talk about ESPN. Now, for those of y'all who don't know, ESPN has actually been partnered with EA Sports for some time now. And the biggest representation that I have seen of ESPN in an EA Sports title is in NCAA 14. You see a little bit of it NCAA 14 to me. With what I would like to see more of is more ESPN representation. I think that this will add to the immersion of the game, and with EA Sports not really doing much to represent ESPN in these games, it would be very innovative. It would be really cool to see like what they did with NBA Live, you know, that segment with Skip, Stephen A. Smith, which I like Stephen A. Smith on a personal level, but I have to digress. You know, Stephen A., that's my boy, man. But I like it, you know. It's immersive. It draws you in. It gives you a sense of realism, a sense of simulation, a sense of reality. And I really think that they should implement more of those things into the Madden football franchise mode, as well as, you know, and I hate to bring up 2K, but kind of taking a page out of 2K's book, you know, because you have ESPN now, you know, so utilize that. Implement an ESPN type halftime show. Get my boy John Gruden in there, because I'll tell you what, man, ESPN football and Madden and all the football wonders, you know, it's got me feeling real lovely now. I'll tell you that, man. That's going to be great, man. Now I'm feeling like going to give me a spider through my banana Sunday, if you feel what I'm saying, man. You know, so get some of those guys in there, you know. Get a guy like Frank Caliendo who works for ESPN, you know, with the voice acting and stuff like that. You know, mix it up, you know. Add to the immersion of it, as well as like the post-game shows and things like that, you know, utilize ESPN, because you have a lot of people who watch ESPN, a lot of people who pay attention to ESPN. You have a lot of good content there. Now, I understand, you know, that these things cost money and things of that nature. So, well, I'm going to do that in another video. I'm going to say that for a different video, but you know, money-wise, I understand that it costs money, that you can't put everything into a game, and these are just ideas that will add to the immersion and innovativeness of Madden NFL football. I think that a lot of people would be extremely happy to see ESPN represented more in the game with score trackers and things of that nature. You know, I would like to see it more, because it feels more like you're actually watching television, you're actually living these things out, and thus adds to the simulation factor of the game. And I think that ESPN would also be happy to be represented more, especially in a professional game such as Madden. And people may agree or disagree with that, but Madden is a professional game. That's why you don't see people getting hit, knocking their helmets off. You don't see the more graphic injuries and things of that nature, you know, because with their contract with the NFL, their partnership rather, you know, they have to stay true to some things that the NFL wants them to stay true to in a simulation-style football game that's representing the NFL. But all in all, like I said, I would like to see more ESPN. I would like to see more analysts taking a page out of NBA Live's book. I like the career mode thing, you know, where Stephen A. and Max Keller sitting there talking about the players and things of that nature. You know, you could throw some more personalities in there, but I think that Stephen A. Smith is the quintessential author, a person that can talk about a football player. He can talk about anything. I tell you what, the Stephen A. Smith can talk about a slice of cheese and make it seem wonderful how it happens to be a 90-degree angle at all corners, yellow and square, but still melty and tastes good in your mouth. Telling you, man, get that boy in there, man. I'm pretty sure, I would be surprised if they didn't implement some of those things in there, seeing as that they've done it with NBA Live. But I digress, man. Those are my thoughts. Those are my opinions. Let's add to it down in the comment section down below. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel if you haven't, y'all, and hit that like button, please. It really helps us to get exposure on YouTube to be able to grow and do bigger things. Till next time, thanks for tuning in, and God bless.